it's SAmaryllis. I'm here to play more Pokemon Sun, and today we're going to head into the Lush Jungle, I think? I'm at Route 5 right now, but... Okay, yeah, here we go. This is where we enter. Yes, it makes a loop on the map, so... Pretty sure this was blocked off before, but we're gonna head in there now. And I guess it will be Mallow's trial site. Thanks for stopping by. Welcome to Lush Jungle, the trial grounds for me, Mallow. I knew it the first time I saw you and your team. You've chosen only the finest ingredients. That's why I'm gonna make you help me. No. I mean, that's why you should try my trial. You're the one who got the sparkling stone straight from Tapu Koko, aren't you? You're so totally ready for this. Ah, the breath of the jungle. I can tell just what today's special should be. Can you? It took a while to think about it. Yep, it's gotta be. My personal specialty, the Mallow Special. I'm gonna need you to find 4 ingredients for me. I'll need a mago berry, a tiny mushroom, a revival herb, and a miracle seed. Here you go! I brought you a forage bag to hold all the ingredients gathered for your trial. She's just using her captain status to get free items and free labor. If you put the trial ingredients in your own bag, you get mixed up with your stuff, right? When you're hunting for ingredients, you're gonna want to rely on Statlin's help. It'll find things you don't see, after all. You remember what I told you at the farm, right? Just press the B button to use Statlin's search. Okay, one more time. There are 4 things you need to get for me to clear your trial. A magleberry, a tiny mushroom, a revival herb, and a miracle seed. You got that? Okay, then here in Lush Jungle, it's time for Mallow's trial to begin. Alright. I wonder if this means that we have to get these items specially in Lush Jungle. Yeah, I'm not for the big fan of Mitch Jungles. Where are all the comfy machines at, huh? I guess that means that I can't use maybe like a tiny mushroom that I already have. Hold on. Oh, I got some stones from Pokepelago. That's not what I'm here for, though. Forage bag. Okay. I think it has to... You have to find the items here, because I don't think I can move them in there. Into the forage bag, so... Alright, let's get started. Mallow, special tip. Statlin is the best. He's a real pro when it comes to sniffing out primal ingredients. Okay. I guess we're gonna be, sitting on Statlin the whole time. Oh, good. I'm glad the music didn't change. Usually when you're on a ride Pokemon, it's like the ride Pokemon music. I need the tiny mushrooms. Here we go. But the big mushroom attacked! I was gonna say, like, what would happen if I picked a big mushroom? Oh, a Parasect! Yo, did I just try and pick up a giant Pokemon and didn't notice all the pincers and stuff under it? Okay, I should probably switch Will out from being the first one because, grass is gonna be ineffective for sure, and then if there's gonna be bugs, like this Parasect, then it's gonna be a bad time for my buddy here. And I'm still over-leveled, and I still don't really understand how this happened, because whenever I, like, try and find Pokemon in the wild grass, like, I always use a B-team. I don't bring my main team in there. Alright, well, that's okay. Cross-Poison didn't do as much damage as I thought, which is good. Good job, Cody. And this Parasect is out of there. I almost wonder if I should bring my B-team into the jungle. Oh well. Hey, it's me, Mallow. Ooh, a tiny mushroom. That's great. There's a secret to why they're so popular with some people. You'll have to try one to find out what it is. Still 3 ingredients left to get. You still need a whole big helping. Is she following me? Jeez, Mallow. Can't you trust me to do this on my own? Oh, okay. I guess I'm going to a different area. What's this tip say? Many Pokemon love berries, so be sure to add them to your cooking whenever you can. Thanks, Mallow. Oh. Ooh, there's a TM back there. Oh, also I can take a picture? I have priorities. Ooh! Okay, this... How do I zoom again? There you go. Face me. I feel like I'm Crom whenever I say that. Since Fire Emblem, he always says, face me. Come on, buddy. I want to photograph your cute face. Preferably if you do something cute, too. You gonna do anything cute? Ooh, there's... Aww. So cute! Okay. Good. Yeah, he made, Rotom made some fancy noises, so I'm guessing those are gonna get some good feedback there. Hey, the little jumping guy. Yes. Alright. Still a little bit small. Okay, that's some 4,000. Good, good, good. Oops, stop. I always do that. Oh, I wanted to see if there may be a different Pokemon I could photograph. It seems like a few places have, hey, different Pokemon available. Is this your back? Pretty sure this is the back. Turn around. Please turn around. Okay. Okay, alright. Just wanted to spin and not look at me. That's okay. I'll do this one. Sure. I guess it's good enough for an amateur. Thanks. Yeah, I didn't get that good of a score. Okay, so let's keep going. There is an item around a shaking bush. Let's go over to the suspicious bush. Tree. Oh, gosh. Oh, I forgot to switch Will out for being my first Pokemon. Alright, Fomantis. I'm pretty sure Fomantis has some bug moves, too. But I remember this Pokemon was really weak. Yeah, breathing in perfect sync. Okay. Yeah, I will for sure after this to remember to switch Will out from being my first one in the party. Razor Leaf. Oh, it didn't use, like, its bug move. Okay. It was a critical hit. We're gonna do a chomp to get this little flower bug out of here. Even though it looks like a bug, it's actually just a grass type, I think. Very disappointing. Okay. Oh, M grew. See, M is like almost level 30. Electro Ball. Sure, what is that? Faster the user is. Okay, M is really slow, so we're not gonna learn Electro Ball. Can I sniff something out here? Oh wait, before I forget, I'm gonna switch Will out from being first. Okay, and then we're not gonna have Marvel first, because Marvel is weak against grass. Yeah, these two at the bottom, I don't want to bring them out if I can, because they won't be strong against them. Can I just... Oh, I have to search here. There's a berry in the ground. Okay, I don't have to try and decide which berry I need. Mallow. Hey, it's me, Mallow! Congrats on finding that Magoberry! The bigger and more twisted a Magoberry, the sweeter it will taste. Still two more ingredients left to get, just a little more to find. Okay, nothing left here. And we just need two more ingredients, which I don't really remember, and I do want to get that item at one point or another. Maybe I can get it if I circle through this way. Oh, here's an item right here. I can't get it. Let's grab it now. A super potion. Okay, let's get back on Statland. Oh, too fat. Okay, there we go. Oh, there is an item around here. Well, I thought there was. I did a little exclamation point. Okay, well, there's maybe an item here. Is it like down here in the grass? In this open spot right here? Yeah. Oh, an X defense. Okay. I don't need that item, but I'll take it. Nothing left here? Okay, let's go. Maybe this will bring me to that yellow TM. Which way, buddy? Special tip, revival herbs are shorter than nearby grasses, and they revive whoever eats them, so they're great to add to any dish. Okay, so we have to try and find some smaller grass. Like right here? Yeah, right there. Suspicious looking grass. Yes, I will pull it up. It's a revival herb. Pokemon gonna jump out too? Yes. Is it gonna be another Fomantis? Or maybe a Bone Sweet this time? Nope, it's a Fomantis. There's Mallow again. Hey, it's me, Mallow, in case you forgot who she was. That's a fine revival herb. Its bitter bite is even a shock to Pokemon, but that's what will add depth to the flavor. Just one last ingredient left, go back out there and find it. So, once you get knocked out by this revival herb, then the revive that you put in will help bring you back. Or I guess that's why it's the revival herb, right? You become so shocked. Where's the item? Where's the item? Where is it? Oh, it's right there? That's a weird place. Hyper potion, just right in the middle of the path. Okay. Anything else, buddy? Nope, nothing over here. Okay. One last area to explore. And it's not this way. Wait, hold on. Is this a path? A tiny path that Statlin cannot walk in? Yes, it is, and there's an item! A max revive. Okay, I still have not forgotten about that yellow TM from back in that other area. I do want to get it at one point or another. Okay, let's try my Statlin here. Nope, nothing here. Yeah, okay, next area. What's this tip say? When Pokemon bury seeds in the ground, they give an especially rich and complex flavor. So we gotta find some seeds in the ground, eh? Okay, I'm gonna have to charge past that, probably. Okay, I'm gonna have to charge past a lot of things here. Oh! I don't have a Machop or Machamp or whatever I need for that yet, so that's too bad. I'm gonna charge right through there, and I guess we'll charge through here too, and then we'll give Statland a sniff. Oh, there's something over here. Right? Right? Okay, something here. I didn't actually need to bust that part open, so I guess, oh well. Maybe something over here? Maybe down here? Oops, gotta get the Taurus out. Yeah! Oh, that looks suspicious. There's a seed buried in the ground. It's a miracle seed. Is the Pokemon gonna come? Nope, just Mallow. Hey, it's me, Mallow! That's a great miracle seed. Miracle seeds are bursting with nutrition. They really are a miraculous gift from the jungle. Ooh, looks like you got everything. Okay, it's time for us to start cooking, so come on back to the entrance of the jungle. Alright, Mallow, just leave me behind here. It's fine. Does this loop back to the entrance? Oh, I can jump. Here's an item. A big root. I think that boosts grass type moves, huh? Nothing here. Sniff and sniff. Nope. Oh, there she is. Hey, Mirabelle. Great, now that we've got all the ingredients, we just need... a trial Pokemon? Sorry to keep you waiting. Oh, Kiawe! How are you, Mallow? Lana and Kiawe are here. Are we gonna have a big old potluck? I brought a thick club and a rare bowl. Is that for like a soup or... And I brought you some fresh water and the usual Rocky helmet. Is it gonna be like a soup then? Like we put it in the Rocky helmet? Oh my gosh. Oh, we have to lure out the totem Pokemon. Okay, Mallow. Let me see what you got for me. One Mago Berry, check. One Tiny Mushroom, check. One Revival Herb, check. One Miracle Seed, check. Perfect, just what the recipe calls for. Now I can make the Mallow special. Here I was thinking she was just trying to profit. Ooh, time for us to get cooking, partner. We'll have that totem Pokemon here in a flash. The aroma of this tasty dish will draw that totem Pokemon right to us. Ready to start cooking? Yes. I thought she was just trying to benefit herself and make, like, some dish, but I guess we needed to call the Pokemon out. Okay, Lana, flip that Rocky helmet over and let's pour that fresh water into it. Here you are. Then in go the Mago Berry, the Tiny Mushroom, the Revival Herb, and the Miracle Seed. Kiawe, let's use that thick club and that rare bone for a minute. Here you are. Okay, Mirabelle, grab the thick club and the rare bone and pound it all to a pulp. Pound. Oh, okay, I have to actually pound it. It was, like, making sounds, but... Crush it! Okay, I did. Yep, turn into goo. Oh, gosh. A unique aroma begins to waft around the area. If you're a piercing gaze from somewhere within the underbrush. Oh, boy. Oh, my God, look at her face. Whoa! What a beautiful Pokemon! The Lantis, the totem Pokemon of Lush Jungle, has appeared. It's so pretty! Oh, Totem Lurantis. Okay, speed rose sharply. Go on, Cody. Try your best, buddy. Okay, good, good. Starting strong. This might be too strong with my Fire Fang, but... X-Scissor. Ah! We're okay, we're okay. Yeah, is this gonna go as quickly as the last two? Or, not the last two, just Kiawe's was really fast. Lana's took a long time, in terms of prep. Ooh, a cast form! That's different. I don't know what type that is. But we're gonna use this new Flame Burst I got, which attacks both Pokemon. Synthesis. Wow. How much will that heal? Okay, half of it. So the whole thing. Okay, bring it back down. Hit the cast form! Oh, it only did like a tiny bit of damage! I thought it would do a lot more! I was so excited about this move. Sunlight turned harsh. Forecast. What is... does it turn into a... Ah! It turned into like a little sun! Whoa! Okay, what... Intimidate... Ferium... Okay, I want to see Sunny Day. Boost the type of fire type moves and lowers the power of water attack moves. I mean... I guess if I had a bug Pokemon out, Cast Form would destroy it, but other than that, it just seems like I'm going to destroy Lurantis here even more with Sunny Day. Maybe Synthesis does more healing in the harsh sun? I'm unsure. I mean, it healed all the way, but I don't know what it's normally like. Super effective. Yeah, it did way more damage. Headbutt. Okay. You know what I should use? I should use Ferium Z. Inferno Overdrive. Oh, there's two different ones. Why are there two different ones? Is it because I have two fire moves? Okay, that's special. Oh, okay. So I can pick if I want, special or not. So this one's 140, and this one's 120. But Fire Fang... plays more to Cody's strength. Oh, you still went first? Okay, fine. Okay, we're gonna do a little dance here. I'm sure Kiawe will be proud. Okay, go for it, Cody. Smush the Lurantis with your fire. Burn the whole forest down, why don't you? Jeez. Alright, Lurantis is down. Goodbye. Headbutt. Okay. Okay, Cody. You did a great job. I'm going to switch you out now to Marvel, actually. Marvel had a use after all. Marvel and Ollie E, that is. I did not expect a cast form to come. I thought, like, those little Fomantises would come. I mean, that's kind of been what the totem Pokemon have been like so far. It's like, it's been either the same Pokemon or, like, the lesser evolution. Okay, we're going to do a high horsepower and get rid of this cast form here. I didn't even think if it had Levitate, but it shouldn't, right? Because it had the ability after it did Sunny Day. Oops. Okay, Marble grew. Good job, buddy. Nice. Look at that attack stat. So high. Iron Defense. Sure. What is this? Sharply raising its defense stat. Okay. I'll get rid of Mud Slap. Yeah, because it's basically like a sand attack, just with a tiny bit of attack on it. Anyone else leveled up? Okay, Will did. Wants to learn Charm. What is Charm? Probably lowers defense, right? Harshly lowers attack stat. I really like the moves I have. Maybe I should get rid of Leech Seed? I mean, I do usually learn moves when they're like harshly lowers or harshly raises, but like, how often do I really use them? Like, even compared to like Leech Seed or something. Okay, we'll get rid of Leech Seed. We'll do Charm instead. Ollie Eager too. Wow, hello. Totem Lurantis is out of here. Wow, Maribel, you're strong, huh? You were really able to draw the flavor of your Pokemon in that battle. The totem Pokemon bowed right down to you. That was a lot harder than Kiawe's trial. Yes, even back at Whaley Volcano Park, my vaunted Salazzle didn't stand a chance. Nor did the Wishiwashi that I had trained so carefully. Alright, you cleared all three of Akala's trials. You even managed to get through my trial, and I'd say it's a real doozy. Here, a gift for such an inspiring young trainer. Probably would have been a lot harder if I wasn't furiously overleveled. But okay, I guess I'll take it. Here we go! Completed the trial in Lush Jungle. Okay. See Christopher Mallow. Let me show you the grass type Z moves. You go like this. Grass. Okay? Oh no. Okay, it's like a blooming flower. Since you've cleared my trial, Maribel, I want you to help me train some Pokemon from here in Lush Jungle. Here, have some nest balls. Thank you. So kind. Looks like Lurantis didn't finish all the food. Ooh, I really want you guys to try some. Have a bite, Kiawe. You too, Lana. If you insist. Lick. How is it? The flavor from the rare bone seems to fill my whole mouth. It tastes so good you might melt. No, wait. Is that my tongue that's melting? Oh, gosh. It's so spicy. What? What's wrong with you guys? Don't you have any taste? Are you headed off to Olivia's for the grandchild? She just leaves all her ingredients there. Woo, what a sweet smell I smell. Drifting my way? Could it be that tasty Mallow special? I heard you cleared Mallow's trial, yeah? Alright then, I have a present for you. That little TM right there is a smart strike, a move that will never miss. So basically another Swift. Swift is actually... I mean, it's okay now, but Swift is not a strong move. There'll be all kinds of discoveries and new experiences to make your adventure brighter. There's a facility, yeah, that I want you to go check out on your island challenge. The Dimensional Research Lab. Let's get on over there with extreme speed. Are we not going to talk about how he was at the wrestling thing? Hey there, Maribel. I guess I should congratulate you on clearing all three of Akala Island's trials. Congrats! Looks like it's time for you to go take on Kahuna Olivia's grand trial. Olivia's an expert user of rock-type Pokemon. You're going to want to catch some grass-type Pokemon in Lush Jungle to add to your team. Whenever you're ready for the grand trial, come see me at the Dimensional Research Lab. It's down past Route 6, yeah? But you just ask Rotom if you need some help. Okay. Didn't the professor tell you to head for that Dimensional Research Lab? Not yet. We're gonna go back to Lush Jungle. Actually, let me look at Smart Strike to see how much damage it does. Here it is. 70. A sharp horn. Okay, so you need to have a Pokemon with a horn, which none of mine have. So that's too bad. A big root. Boost amount of HP that Holder recovers from HP stealing moves. Ooh, that'd be really good for my Will here. It's that or equip Grassium? Z? But, yeah, I mean, you can only use a Z move once per battle anyway, so, like, there's not really a point. Like, for Cody to use Fire MZ against Olivia, it sounds like, because she has Rock Pokemon. Oops. Upgrade Grass-type moves to Grass-type Z moves. Okay, so just Will. Let's see. I'm gonna run back to the Pokemon Center really quick, and then I'll try and pick up any Pokemon from Lush Jungle. Okay, so I brought my B team into the Lush Jungle, and Robert is evolving, I guess. I think he's level 16 now, so I guess he's going to evolve into the second form after Lillipup, which I forgot the name of. It's not Stoutland yet, but it's like the terrier. Herdier. That would make sense, because it's like a terrier. So it's a Herdier now. Good job, Robert. You now look less naked, because your cape looks bigger. Okay. Its dense black fur grows continuously. The high cost of keeping its hard fur properly groomed makes this a troublesome Pokemon to train. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, and he's poisoned. Okay, so I've been leveling in the Lush Jungle, and as you can see, Aiden is evolving. I read online that as long as you level up your Eevee in Alola, in the Lush Jungle by the moss-covered rock, it will evolve into a Leafeon, which I honestly think they could have done a much better job explaining, because, like, when I see Leafstone, I think, yeah, I'll use that, just like I use the Firestone, Thunderstone, and Waterstone to evolve Eevee normally. But, I mean, I guess maybe if you've played previous games with Leafeon, which I haven't, you would know that you need to evolve it in a certain area. But, yeah. Its cellular composition is closer to that of a plant than an animal. It uses photosynthesis to produce its energy supply without eating food. Oh, so does it not eat at all? That's interesting. Okay, well, there's Aiden. Aiden wants to learn Razor Leaf. Yes, let's forget something here. Let's see. 55. Oh, it's a physical move, actually. Alright, well, I'm going to get rid of Helping Hand, because I don't actually play, like, doubles very often, anyway. But yeah, I think, like, if they had given some sort of hint in-game, like, maybe, like, an NPC will tell you if you ask about it, or if, like, there was a sign about the mysterious rock, I think that would have been a lot more helpful, because otherwise, like, if I hadn't gone on the internet, or, like, maybe if someone hadn't played a previous game, like, you wouldn't have known about it, honestly. And, like, when I was in the Lush Jungle, like, I didn't even think about, like, that's so cute. You're a cutie, aren't you? Are you mad about the leaf? I can't tell what that face is. Oh, no, it's a good face. What are you unhappy about? The leaf. Okay. Yeah. Don't touch the chest leaf. But, yeah. There wasn't even, like, a sign or Mallow didn't say, like, oh, rumor has it if you bring an Eevee. Because, like, it's this rock right here. Surface covered with moss. Like, if you... There's just no way of knowing unless you actually knew about it beforehand. So that's what I'm not happy about. But anyway, I'm going to keep on fighting because there's, like, three Pokemon that I want in this area, and I have not seen a single one so far because they have very low chances of appearing. 2 at 5%. Oh, well, perfect. Here's a Pinsir, which has a 20% chance of appearing. So that hasn't been, I guess, too long of a fight to get this, but... Paper Cutter. Okay, attack was not lowered. Yeah, two other Pokemon only have a 5% chance of appearing, so that's gonna take me a while, I think. But I'm gonna start off with a Thunder Wave. Okay, Robert might die instantly because this is a fighting move, and he's... Okay! He's okay. That's very confusing. I mean, like, Robert is normal type, and Seismic Toss, pretty sure, is a fighting type move. Unless Seismic Toss does, like, a fixed amount of damage, which would confuse me. But that's okay. Pinsir is paralyzed now, and that's what matters, so we're gonna do one bite. Because Takedown is really strong. I don't know how strong it would be. Okay, maybe I'll use Takedown. Because, like, Bite did so little damage. I'm gonna suffer some recoil here, but that's okay. As long as Robert can hit something. Okay, Robert's dead. Goodbye. I thought Revenge would only do, like, the damage you suffered that turn, but I guess not. Okay, so it has some fighting-type moves. Maybe I'll bring in Agatha, because fighting-type moves shouldn't be able to touch her. But I do want to catch this guy, so I don't want to be, like, too aggressive here. I'll do a Nightshade, because that's fixed damage. I think it does, like, the same damage as your level, so that should be 21 HP. That should be okay. Yeah, okay. And then I'll do one more, and that should be perfect. Sometimes you just gotta go with that fixed damage life, you know? It's actually pretty strong. Especially when... Ha, you can't touch me. Especially when Pokemon are lower leveled, I guess, and they don't actually have that much HP. I'm guessing it gets less effective as your greater levels. Like, although it will do a fixed, like, 60 damage if you're level 60. Like, I actually don't know what HP will be like at level 60. But okay. So it doesn't seem happy about the Pokeball. What if I use the Nest Ball? This does, nope, that's for wild Pokemon. Oh, that is what was given to me. I don't want to use that. I thought it was a Net Ball, but it's a Nest Ball. Let's try a Great Ball then. Because, like, this Pinsir, I mean, it's level 19. It's not, like, super low level. I don't know. We'll see how this great ball does. Promising? Okay, got it. Got ourselves a pincer. Perfect, perfect. That was a lot of experience. Oh, Lana grew. Lana wants to learn Fury Swipes. Why does Lana only learn bad moves? Like, this only does 18 damage. Well, I guess it's, like, 5 times in a row or whatever. But, like, I guess Nightshade is good. But, like, Infestation is really weak. Shadow Sneak is really weak. Like, String Shot doesn't do any damage. Like, get it together. Get it together. Okay. I almost don't want to learn it. It's like, yeah, I'm not going to learn it. Get rid of that one. Doug grew. Are you going to evolve now, Doug? I've had you for, like, 10 years. Oh, well, Lana's evolving. Okay, well, I'll take it. Hopefully, the next form, what, like, Ariandos is stronger? I mean, what am I saying? It's not like I was planning to add Lana into my party anyway. So it doesn't matter. I almost wonder if it's, like, an issue, like, with Wingull, where, like, it's not actually a weak Pokemon, it just doesn't learn moves conducive to its stat growth, like, very early on. Whatever, what's done is done. Alright. Got this in our decks. And there are some areas where people use the string Ariados spins for their own weaving. The resulting cloth is popular for its strength. That is pretty cool. I've heard, yeah, isn't it that spider silk is actually, like, stronger than steel? It's just so thin that it seems weak. Wants to learn sword stance. Yeah, sure, why not? This sharply raises physical attack, right? Sharply raises, yep. So let's get rid of... I'll get rid of string shot. I know it sharply lowers speed, but... I'll take this instead. Even though, at least, Lana's pre-evolved form was very slow. So maybe I should have kept that. I don't know. Yes! Doug is finally evolving! How many episodes has it been where Doug has just been sitting there like a lump in the sand, as my one friend likes to remind me? Oh, alright. There we go. We finally got ourselves a Doug trio, and their hair has grown out fabulously. The evolution music is a little different. Is it because it's a Lola form? Kind of curious about that. And it also had a green background when it was evolving. I don't know if that's special for Alola forms or not. Okay. Its shining gold hair provides it with protection. It's reputed that keeping any of its fallen hairs will bring bad luck. Oh. You would think it would bring good luck because it provides it protection. Okay. Alright, there we go. Oh, Doug wants to learn Sand Tomb. What does Sand Tomb do? For 4 to 5 turns. Harshly Raging, though. I'll get rid of Mud Bomb. Yeah. Okay. Mud Bomb is gone, and now there's Sand Tomb. Tomb and Bomb look like they should rhyme, but they don't, because English is strange. Okay, well, here's our pincer. Wow, a lot has happened in this one battle. Alright. Perfect. It grips its prey in its pincers and splits them apart. Although it is a powerful Pokemon, it can't deal with the cold. Okay. Alright. Its mouth really freaks me out. I don't like it. Okay, well, we'll name you Petey. Did I already name a Pokemon Petey? I almost feel like I have. Oh well. Petey can go to the box. Okay, perfect. And now the only two Pokemon left are the ones that only have a 5% chance of appearing. So it might take me a long time to get there. Okay, so one of the Pokemon that only had a 5% chance of appearing did appear, Comfy. It didn't actually take as long as I thought it would. But again, I still have one more 5% chancer that I need to get to. So anyway, I'm gonna swap to Robert so that I can lay down my Thunder Wave. And we should be off to a good start here with Comfy. Magical Leaf. Okay. I'm gonna start with a Thunder Wave. Uh-oh. I don't know what type Comfy is. I know it's grass for sure, because, I mean, it's made of flowers. But, I don't know if it's part fairy or not. I'm, like, a little worried. Oh, no! Did I fight a Comfy before? Oh, in the totem battle! Okay, perfect. So then I can see that bite doesn't do that much. Or at least is not effective. Definitely not effective. I'm worried of using takedown, because that might be too strong. I mean, it's power 90, so maybe I bring in... What kind of moves do you have? Absorb, Fury Cutter. No. What about you? Infestation, Bubble. Isn't this a grass type? Why would Bubble be effective? Very confused. Maybe I'll bring in Agatha. Oops. Maybe I'll bring in Agatha because Agatha has the fixed HP nightshade. And I'm pretty sure it should have at least 21 HP, right? Oh boy. Is Agatha in love? You gonna hurt yourself, Agatha? Okay, we're gonna use a nightshade. Perfect, perfect. One more nightshade might actually be too much. Let's try Thief instead. Shouldn't do too much damage because it's a dark type move. Ah! Especially if Agatha attacks herself. Oh, okay, Agatha. One more try for Thief. Okay, that really did no damage. Like, I know I don't want to hurt it too much, but that was just too little damage. Okay, well, maybe if I confuse it, it'll hurt itself. Just like a little bit. I just want it to hurt itself like once. And then I don't want it to hit itself anymore after that. Hurt yourself? Yes. Actually, one more might be good. Okay, I'll do one Thief. Oh, look at how cute it is. I wonder how much of it is the actual Pokemon and how much of it is just, like, it carrying flowers. Okay, well, I think it's still a little confused, but I'll throw a Pokeball just in case it feels amiable and wants to come with me after I beat it up in battle. Okay, no good. Oh, it's no longer confused. But now Agatha's going to be confused. That's okay, I can control it better when I use Thief. So I'll just, oops, I want to use another Thief. As long as Agatha's not confused and attack herself. Okay. Now it's in the red. Maybe I should use one more Thief. This Clumpy's probably like, why do you keep trying to pickpocket me? I have nothing in my pockets. I have no pockets. Okay. Let's see how it feels about a Pokeball now. It popped out of the first one so quickly, I wonder if I should just upgrade to a Great Ball or something. But maybe I'll get it. Yes, there we go. Yay. Got ourselves a Comfy. And Agatha leveled up. Good job, my girl. And it's an okay level up. I mean, special attack went up a lot. Let's still learn Sucker Punch. Man, all these, like, dark moves and, like, their small side effects. It does a lot of damage, but only if the other Pokemon's gonna also attack. How much does Thief do? 60. This only has 5 PP. I'm not gonna learn this. Oh, Delilah grew. Robert grew. Good job. Oh, Perry grew. Okay. Oh, Freddy grew as well. Oh, Freddy's growing a lot. Learned Bite. Okay, good job, little buddy. And we got ourselves a Comfy. It's pretty cute. I do like it. Maybe, like, this twig part is its body and it collects flowers. Maybe the Pokedex will have some info. It attaches flowers to its highly nutritious vine. This revitalizes the flowers and they give off an aromatic scent. Okay, so that the vine is part of it, I guess. It is Posy Picker. Because it collects posies. But, like, why isn't it grass fairy type? Why is it only a fairy type? Like, it has a vine on it. You know? Oh, it's only 4 inches big? That's so small! It's like a little bracelet or like a ring. So I thought it might be more of like a necklace. Like the flower lays they have. But I guess not. Oh, not Leo. Leia. Okay. We're gonna put you in the box. Alright, good deal. Just one more Pokemon and I can leave this place. Okay, so again, while I'm in the Lush Jungle, Bouncy gained a level while knowing the move Stomp. Again, this is a very specific condition. And I think it's level 36 now. I did have Bouncy level up in the Pogopelago. In the meantime... Whoa! Zarina, huh? It's like plant cap got really long and it's like a little fleshy fruit part got really small. Okay, well, I guess the evolution makes sense. It you know, continuously gets more legs. Okay. There's Zarina right there. Its long, striking legs aren't just for show, but to be used to kick with skill. In victory, it shows off by kicking the defeated, laughing boisterously. Wow. Certainly sounds very victorious. My friend Gwen said that Zarina's actually well-used in competitive Pokemon? I don't know if that's true or not, but that's what she told me when I was so frustrated about how weak Bouncy was before evolving, and even after evolving. Wants to learn Trop Kick. Trop. What a strange word. I've never heard of trop before, actually. Lands an intense kick of tropical origins. That might be what's called trop kick. On the target. This also lowers the target's attack stat. Wow, and its power is 70? That's so strong. And look at the attack now. It's 115. I'm definitely getting rid of Magical Leaf because it's a special type move. Jeez, that's almost too big of an extreme here, huh? Oh, gosh. I guess if you persevere, you get rewarded with this crazy evolution. Crazy strong evolution, should I say. Alright, I still have not encountered my... what was it? My last 5% chance Pokemon, but... at least Bouncy evolved! And actually, I'm gonna go run back and swap out Bouncy, but I did want to kind of share my thoughts about Pokapilago, because... while... I really like certain aspects of it, but like other parts aren't even really worth using, in my opinion. So like the level up feature in that one island that lets you level up Pokemon, I used it maybe too vigorously, I guess. Like I got too excited about expanding my island and having as many Pokemon as possible, you know, hanging out, leveling, doing stuff. I mean, maybe that island is good for if you want to just like strengthen a certain Pokemon's like stat, I think you can also do, but like what I used it for, like leveling up, which, you know, what the island sounds like, it's actually not that great because in just a few days, like, I did, like, the maximum training time or whatever, and in just a few days, like, a lot of my Pokemon leveled up really high, so, oh, comfy. I was like, what is that large thing here? So, like, Tentacool, I caught it at, like, level 15 or something, and now it's level 30, and, like, I don't know when it evolves specifically, but, like, some of them, let's say Spearow, like, it's, like, level 30 now, and it's still a Spearow, or, like, other Pokemon that should have evolved, but, like, they didn't because they leveled up using Pokapelago. Like, 31, I'm pretty sure Brenda should have evolved by now, right? I mean, maybe not, but I feel like yes. But, what other Pokemon did I put in Pokapelago? Like, this one, it's, like, level 34 now. I'm pretty sure it should have leveled up by now. Kihei. Well, Kihei, your Bone Sweet is really strong now. I'm gonna take back my Oranberry. Because, I need to find a better example here, but, like, a lot of Pokemon that I left there... like, oh, okay, here we go, here's a good example. So, like, Vullaby, which I got through Wonder Trade, I'm pretty sure it evolves at 54, like, 54 specifically, that level, but because I stuck it in Pokapelago, it didn't end up leveling, so now it's just like, alright, well, now I have to, eventually, when I'm strong enough to make this Vullaby listen to me, which is level 54 now, I'm gonna have to level it again one more time, so that it'll actually evolve, and it, like, maybe... the Alola Meowth was also supposed to maybe evolve. I don't actually know. It might actually be one of the later 30 evolutions, like the Grimer. But yeah, so, I mean, it has its uses. I understand, like, the point of it, but at the same time, when you put the Pokemon there, kind of like in the Pokemon daycare, it's like you put it in a hotel, you never use this Pokemon until it's, like, leveled up, and, like, you can, to some extent, control the moves that it learns, because it, like, whenever a new move comes, it overwrites the top one, so you just have to reorder these. And, like, keep the ones you want on the bottom, and then hopefully, you know, it won't overwrite the ones you actually want to keep. But I just, like, is that feeling of not being able to control a Pokemon, like, and how it grows, I guess, is the point. And, like, you know, this bear Pokemon I just caught, like, is already, like, level 30 because I put it in Pokapelago. So, I mean, it doesn't feel like it's your Pokemon, is what I'm trying to say. And, like, I kind of felt the same way with, maybe I shouldn't bring a level 32 because it's almost too high for this area. What I'm trying to say is, like, same thing with the experience share, because, like, Ali-E actually ended up evolving without me even really using him, and that was because of the experience share, and it's that feeling of, like, you're just borrowing this Pokemon, and, like, it just happened to level up, and, like, now it's strong, but, like, you don't get to control which moves it learns, you don't actually know how it levels up, and it just doesn't feel like your Pokemon, you know? So, those are my thoughts about Pokapelago. I mean, I like the rest of the parts, I think, pretty well, but... I don't like the level up feature in that one island. Okay, so those are my thoughts, and I'm gonna go back to trying to catch that one more Pokemon that only has a 5% chance of appearing. Okay, still no sign of that 5% Pokemon I wanted to catch. I did see another Combee though, or not a Combee, Comfy. I do not need another Comfy though, but it was the wrong 5%. I wanted a different Pokemon. And despite Delilah getting, I think Delilah's fainted, but Delilah apparently is evolving. I had a really brutal chain attack from a lot of Fomantises, at least 5, and Delilah was a victim of some of that, but I guess Delilah's gonna evolve anyway. And okay, it looks much more mean now. It still has a bubble on its head though, that's the important part, right? Araquanids. Data will be added. Yeah, it's so angry now. Look at it. And it has, like, the foamy things on its leg, too. I don't know what they're called, but I've definitely seen those before. Okay, it delivers the headbutts with its water bubble on its head. Small Pokemon get sucked into the bubble where they drown. I don't understand how the headbutt doesn't pop the bubble, though, so it must be, like, completely filled of water instead of just, like, a very thin film. There are a lot of questions. I'm not going to go into them too much. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Delilah is dead. Yep, Delilah's dead, but still evolved despite that. So, okay, I'm going to run back to the Poké Center, and hopefully the next time I see you, it's going to be the Pokemon that I actually wanted to catch, but, you know, I bet it's going to be, like, Freddy evolving or something. I mean, Freddy's almost there in terms of level. I'm back, and I was right. I did not catch that, or even see that Pokemon I wanted, but someone is evolving. It's not Freddy. It's Agatha. So we're gonna see how she looks as a Haunter. Yep, big old tongue and disembodied hands. Just what anyone would want out of a girl, right? There we go. Have a Haunter now. And let's see. It strikes at humans from total darkness. Those licked by its cold tongue grow weaker with each passing day until they die. Ah. These good old Pokedex entries in Sun are just, they're really something, aren't they? Oh, Agatha wants to learn Shadow Punch. I don't know what that is, but let's take a look. Oh, it's a ghost move. Attack never misses. I was gonna say, she hasn't very much learned many ghost moves. Like, aside from Nightshade and Confuse Ray, I guess. And Thief does so little damage, I almost want to just replace this. Yeah, I'll replace it. Agatha will be totally useless against a normal-type Pokemon, which are not affected at all by ghost-type moves. But you know what? Whatever. It's fine. Oh, I'm going to go look up if I can catch this Pokemon at a higher catch rate anywhere else, because this is just like... it's like that Eevee hunt all over again. So I'll come back to y'all with my answer. So Freddy's evolving, and the answer is... No, this area is the only place you can encounter this Pokemon at 5% appearance rate, and it is a version exclusive. So, I have never come across a Pokemon that's version exclusive that was so difficult to find. Like, it's only in this area at 5% appearance rate. So, it's kind of frustrating for me. Like, in like Red, Blue, and Yellow and things like that, like, you encountered Vulpix and Growlithe, like, very easily. Or, like, I think it was Black, I think. Pokemon Black. Maybe. But, okay, anyway, we got ourselves a charger bug now. Its body is capable of storing electricity. On camping trips, people are grateful to have one around. Definitely looks like a little tiny bus. Wow. Okay. So, Freddy wants to learn charge. Okay, sure, why not? Let's see what it is. Boosts electric move that uses in the next turn. Also raises special defense. I'm not gonna learn it. Yeah, and as you can see here, Freddy has a really strange, like, moveset repertoire. Like, there's the electric move, which, like, sure, it's a bug electric type, and bug bite, but then, like, it also learns acrobatics and bite, and it's just very strange. Strange Pokemon. So, Freddy did not learn charge, and I still have not caught a persimmon, or whatever that is, the monkey thing that looks like a persimmon. And now it appears when I start badmouthing it. Who knew that that was all I needed to do was to say, why can't I encounter a Passimian? Passimian, I think that's what it is. It actually looks like it has like a cantaloupe on its head, which is interesting. I would not have expected that. So let's just start off with Robert, so I can do a Thunder Wave on this. And then I can slowly whittle down this thing's HP, because I need to be so careful not to make this faint, because it has taken me literal hours to come across this guy. Is that an electric, or fight move? Hit one time. No! Not down this path! Shoot! Freaking Trumbeaks! They're so strong! Okay, well let's put a Thunder Wave. Is nothing easy? Nothing is easy. I bet the Trumbeak's gonna use the same thing. Oh no! Trumbeak did that. I also had a lot of trouble with Trumbeaks because it kept plucking berries from my Pokemon. So it would heal itself too, and then plus Trumbeak is just really strong, so there's a lot of frustrating things. while trying to find this Pissimian. But hopefully, this will be the end of it. I just need to get rid of this Trumbeak and then hope the Pissimian doesn't ask for more people to come help. I actually taught Robert Rock Tomb specifically because of all these Trumbeaks that I was encountering. Okay, well now Robert's dead, so, you know, that's whatever. Who cares? It's fine. Okay, so we gotta get rid of the Trumbeak. Freddy's gonna be weak because he's bug. But maybe I can move fast enough where it'll be okay? I doubt it, honestly. But girls gotta try, right? So let's use a spark on this Trumbeak. Okay, Freddy might be dead. Hold on, Freddy. Okay, you're doing alright. I think your electric dual typing helped you. Okay, Trumbeak's paralyzed. I don't know what beat up does, and that makes me nervous. Why was I hit only one time? Like, it's a lot of questions. Okay. I'm gonna use another spark just in case the Trumbeak moves ahead of me for some reason and uses Roost. Okay, I didn't need to worry about that, but, you know, it has happened to me. It has happened to me. Receiver. Skill Link. Skill Link was taken over. So does that mean it has Keen Eye now? The Pissimian? Scary face. Does it sharply lower my speed? Yes. Okay. I don't know what's going to be effective against this. I think it's a Psychic Grass type, but I don't know. How much damage does Spark do? 65. Okay, I'm going to use Spark, and hopefully it'll be okay. Because, like, I don't know if the other stuff that I have, which is, like, Bug, what else do I have with Freddy? I'm not sure. Okay, Bug or Dark? Yeah, I don't know if they'll be super effective or not, because I don't know the typing of this. And I don't want to use Acrobatics, because Freddy's not holding anything, which will, I think, like, almost double the, critical hit. It still only hit one time, I don't understand. I don't want to use Acrobatics because Freddy's not holding anything, and I think it doubles attack, or it greatly increases it or something, I don't really know. I still don't understand beat up. Freddy's surviving, though. Okay, I'm going to try catching it, and I'm going to use a timer ball. Because it has been several turns already. And hopefully that will let me catch this Pissimian, which I have wandered in the grass for hours to find. Yes! Thank you! Oh my goodness gracious. Thank you, Freddy. Yes, please grow. Good job, good job. Piper grew, too. Good job, Piper. The Spellbim I got in Wonder Trade grew, which I don't know its nickname. Wow. There it is. A version exclusive monkey, which took me like 2 hours to find because it was a 5% appearance rate in a single area. They form groups of roughly 20 individuals. Their mutual bond is remarkable. They will never let down a comrade. It's funny that you say that they form groups of 20 individuals because the friend it called was a Trumbeak, and then also it took me so long to encounter it. You would think there would be more if they were in groups of 20. Definitely not salty about this. You can definitely tell, right? Oh, it's a lady. Hey, does that mean if I breed it within an egg group, I can get more Pissimians? Is that how breeding works? That would be really nice if anyone needs a Pissimian. I can maybe help you out, maybe, if I understand this right. Okay, well, let's name you Candy for, what, Donkey Kong's girlfriend from, like, 64? Is that, like, a thing in just that game, or in multiple games? That's, like, the only Donkey Kong game I've ever played, so I don't know. Okay. And with that, I can finally say thank you everyone for watching. This has been SAmaryllis playing Pokemon Sun. I am finally done with the Lush Jungle after finally catching the Pissimian. I hope you have a great day, and please remember to be kind to yourself and to others. Bye!